there's literally one thing you can do to improve your ChatGPT and AI game, it's crafting a perfect prompt. It's a seemingly small skill, but with an absolutely massive payoff. Even just a basic beginner understanding can make a big difference in how you can leverage artificial intelligence. I'm Erin from SiteGround, and today we're going to get into the fine art of the ChatGPT prompt formula. And as with any art, the more you practice, the better you'll get. And let me tell you, I practice every darn day. Seriously. When I prompt ChatGPT, I really think about it as my own personal assistant. One that I'm training, so I need to give it precise instructions and background. With that in mind, today we're breaking down the strategy behind this training, prompts, into stages from beginner to advanced. We'll discuss how simple prompts can give you great results and how, as you level up, you can refine your requests to get even more specific and strategic responses. And if you're not in the mood to take notes, no worries. We're including a link to a cheat sheet below with all the coming prompt formulas. Okay, now it's time to change a relationship with AI, from being a repository for aimless questions to that dream personal assistant who understands how to follow your instructions pretty much every time. But before we get started, please don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell so that you don't miss any of our videos. Beginner. Let's kick it off with the basics, beginner level prompts. At this stage, a simple structure can get you really far. The general formula for crafting a basic prompt is context plus task plus format. Don't be fooled by its simplicity. This approach is incredibly powerful. Here's how it works. Context. The context is the background information you give ChatGPT. This is where you tell it about your project, goal, or what's going on in your world. Think of it like setting the stage for the conversation. The more context you provide, the better ChatGPT can understand your request and give you a response that actually helps. For example, let's say I own an online store selling premium extra virgin olive oil and I'm planning a launch event for my new harvest oil. Also, true story guys, I am a certified olive oil sommelier. Yeah, it's a thing. A simple context might be, I run an online store selling premium extra virgin olive oil. I want to hold an event for 100 people to celebrate the release of my new harvest olive oil. The event will include farmers, influencers, retailers, and my investors. This gives ChatGPT the context it needs, that I'm running an online business that sells olive oil, and I need help with planning for my seasonal harvest event. ChatGPT now understands that I'm asking for advice related to hosting an event, helping it generate relevant and useful suggestions. Basically, the context helps ChatGPT understand what I'm asking and why. Next is the task. This is where you define exactly what you want ChatGPT to do. Do you need advice, a list of ideas, a detailed plan? Imagine exactly what kind of information you need and don't be afraid to tell ChatGPT precisely that and be specific. For example, if I want advice on event planning, I could say, please suggest a detailed list of things to consider for an outdoor launch event, including venue, catering, guest list, entertainment, and promotional materials. The task is really the core of my request. The clearer it is, the better ChatGPT can deliver exactly what I need. Format. Format includes telling ChatGPT how I want the answer to be presented. This could be a bullet list, a 100-word paragraph, or even a table. For example, provide a table with each of the key areas you suggested for my launch event, along with considerations. Please also include additional columns for estimated cost and due dates. So let's piece these three elements together: context, task, and format. A beginner prompt might look like this. I run an olive oil store selling premium extra virgin olive oil. I want to hold an event and blah, 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 you get the point. Please suggest a list of things I need to consider and put it in a table, including additional columns for estimated cost and due dates. And that's it. With just these three elements, you can get insanely useful results for many tasks. Mind you, it's always good to double check the data ChatGPT provides you, but regardless, it offers an incredible starting point with this simple beginner formula. Context plus task plus format. You might be wondering, can this basic structure really help me with more complex tasks? Absolutely. As you'll come to find, this formula can handle a wide variety of requests. But as you get more comfortable with it, you'll want to take things to the next level. Intermediate. On that note, now that we've got the basics covered, let's talk about how to improve your prompts and make them more specific. This is where the intermediate level comes in. Here, you start adding more layers to the formula to further guide ChatGPT and get better results. Our intermediate level prompt looks like this. context, plus task, plus format, plus examples, plus role, plus tone. Let's break it down. One of the most effective ways to guide ChatGPT is by providing specific examples of the kind of content you want it to produce for you. This could mean sharing an existing blog post, a sample press release, or ad copy you admire. By doing this, you're giving ChatGPT a reference point to understand exactly what you're looking for in terms of style, format, or whatever it is you fancy. Let's say I need to produce product page copy for my new Harvest olive oil. I've already got descriptions written for my other already launched products, so I can just drop in one of my other product descriptions and ask ChatGPT to produce a description similar in style and format for this new product. In this case, I could say, I have an online shop where I sell premium extra virgin olive oil. I'm launching a new product, a new Harvest olive oil. It costs $20, and details and more details. And then I can also say, I need to create an online product description similar in style and format to the one I'm including below. I paste my already existing description, hit enter, and there you have it. A product description based on the format of my example. Done. Role. You can also ask ChatGPT to take on a specific role or persona. By assigning a role, you provide additional context that shapes how ChatGPT generates its reply, ensuring the output aligns with the expertise or perspective you're looking for. Continuing with our example, let's examine some different roles. We might ask ChatGPT to be a marketing expert organizing a launch event, a social media manager promoting the event, or a logistics coordinator preparing schedule details. So we could say, pretend you're a logistics coordinator tasked with organizing my outdoor launch event for my new Harvest olive oil. What should be included in the event timeline? It gives us a thorough and detailed timeline. Now, this is obviously a very loose timeline given that I haven't provided much in the way of details. But again, it all comes down to providing quality context. So if I give ChatGPT timeframes and a better idea of activities, then it will come up with a more accurate timeline. Alternatively, I could just as easily use this timeline to help me decide what needs to be included in my own. You can get even more creative with role assignment, though. You can give ChatGPT a role, such as, let's say, a business investor, and ask it to carry out a mock conversation with you about investing in your product. You can learn more about this and other clever tricks in my video covering ChatGPT hacks that will change your business. Give it a watch. Tone. Okay, so then there's tone. It can completely change the way a copy response feels. Maybe you want a formal professional tone for an investor proposal, or a casual friendly tone for your event's promotional materials and blog post. Specifying this will help you get the vibe you're looking for. For example, let's say I want to create an announcement blurb for my event invitation. In one prompt, after including the context, format, and text, I could also ask ChatGPT to please write my blurb in a professional tone. Then I could create a second prompt asking it to write the blurb in a playful and casual tone. Look at these two responses. We are delighted to invite you to an exclusive outdoor gathering. Versus, join us under the sun to toast to the freshest olive oil in town. And then, join us for an evening of exquisite flavors and meaningful connections. As opposed to, we're celebrating with great company, good vibes, and a taste of liquid gold. As you can see, by also incorporating examples, roles, and tone, you're guiding ChatGPT to produce responses that are more precise, relevant, and catered to what you're looking for. Advanced. At this stage, you're dipping your toes into advanced level prompting. Congrats! You're not just asking for information, you're really shaping the responses to fit your exact needs. This isn't child's play anymore. Our advanced level prompt layers on a few more elements. Context, plus task, plus format, plus examples, plus role, plus tone, plus constraints, plus goal, plus refinement. Let's examine these new components. Constraints. This is where you apply specific limits or rules to narrow the scope of the response. It could mean limiting the number of ideas you want or defining the focus of your request. Basically, you're telling ChatGPT what you want it to do and specifically what you don't want it to do. Let's say, for example, I need some marketing advice for my online olive oil shop. I could set a constraint like, give me 3 strategies for marketing my online olive oil store and focus only on organic, non-paid marketing strategies. By adding this constraint, I ensure that the response will be exactly what I need. Organic marketing strategies, not paid ads or promotions. We're still being really general here, but remember, the more details you can provide, the better. Goal. By identifying our goal, we get more granular and focused with our context. Rather than just saying that we are looking for marketing strategies for our online store, we can elaborate on what our goals are and what we're hoping to accomplish. We're really painting the full picture, start to finish. For example, I need these marketing strategies to help me create buzz for my online olive oil shop via media and in the press, ultimately driving traffic to my website in the next month and increasing my social media following. By specifying my goal, I help ChatGPT align its response with my desired outcome. This way, it's not just offering random scattershot marketing tips, but focusing on strategies that can help me create excitement around my launch event and generate sales in a way that is actually relevant to my needs. Refinement. Once I get a response, I can refine it by asking it to provide more detail, reorganize the information, edit the tone, or otherwise. For example, after receiving 3 marketing strategies, I might say, expand on the second strategy with actionable steps for implementation and provide specific examples related to promoting my online shop. This helps make the response more practical and with step-by-step guidance I can actually follow. So here's an example of an advanced level prompt in action for my store's launch. Imagine you're a marketing consultant specializing in gourmet food. Suggest 3 strategies for increasing awareness of my online olive oil store. I will measure success based on increased traffic to my website, sales, and followers on social media. Focus on strategies that are low cost, under $500, and achievable in a month. I could then follow this prompt by asking ChatGPT to expand on a certain element of its proposal and to provide more detailed steps, as we mentioned before. Notice how this prompt includes constraints, budget and timeline, a clear goal, increasing awareness, and a request for refinement, including actionable steps for implementation. Advanced level prompts are where the real AI magic happens because they allow you to target your requests super precisely. Whether you're tackling a complex marketing campaign for your store launch or managing the finer details of your business strategy, these prompts help you focus on what's most important. Okay, so how are you feeling about your personal assistant now? Pretty awesome, right? Whether your relationship with ChatGPT is just getting started, or perhaps it's been going strong for a while now, becoming acquainted with the beginner, intermediate, and advanced stages of ChatGPT prompting will help you conquer so many aspects of your business and life, let's be honest, and all with a whole lot more confidence and ease. Plus, remember, you can mix and match the different prompt elements and with them create custom prompts that meet your changing needs. It's all about finding what works best for you and your objectives. And don't forget, we've got that handy cheat sheet for you and the resources below. We'd love to hear if you have any unique recommendations. Feel free to leave a comment or share your favorite ChatGPT prompt formula below. See you next time.